So ang pinag-uusapan po natin, wala na po ba yung respeto sa tradisyon na yun? This is the time-honored tradition, Madam Chair. For so long a time, we have kept and observed this. We have upheld this. My question is this committee authorized to set aside or discard the tradition? I move to terminate the budget briefing of the OBP.
If we will be always submitting to this tradition, what happens to the constitutional provision on public office is a public trust, and that we should always be accountable to the people. I hope along with the new breed of legislators are inclined to honor the tradition, contrary to the manifestation of the Honorable Marcoleta. Let us all remember that in all parliamentary proceedings, the majority always rule.
Kakapasok lang na balita. Grabe, kinontra ni Luistro si Marcoleta. Matapos sabihin sundin dapat ang kanyang mosyon, wala nang dapat budget briefing kay VP Duterte. Ayon kay Congresswoman Attorney Jervil Luistro, hindi pwedeng hindi sumagot sa Kongreso si VP Sara. Hindi pwedeng hindi siya matanong ni Luistro. Importanteng matanong saan gagamitin ang budget ni VP Sara, hindi pwedeng sundin ang mosyon ni Marcoleta, wala nang hearing. Approve lang agad sa Kongreso.
First of all, I just wish to make a very short manifestation on the issue earlier. This representation could not relate to the cherished and long-standing tradition because this is the first term of this representation. Nonetheless, I understand that by that tradition, we're supposed to extend parliamentary courtesy and by which we're not supposed to raise questions on the budget of the OVP. However, Madam Chair, I wish to ask the committee if we will be always submitting to this tradition, what happens to the constitutional provision on public office is a public trust, and that we should always be accountable to the people. While this representation defer to the wisdom of the senior members, I wish to manifest that I hope along with the new breed of legislators are inclined to honor the tradition, contrary to the manifestation of the Honorable Marcoleta. However, Madam Chair, what happens if the tradition is not sufficient? What happens if the tradition is not effective? What happens if the tradition does not unite and instead it divides? Let us all remember that in all parliamentary proceedings, the majority always rule. And it is on this light that I wish to commend the chair for immediately proceeding to the division of the House. And when the committee voted for no, it has rendered the issue yes, moot and academic. And I concede to the Honorable Garin that even this representation disregarded this rule. That is a manifestation, Madam Chair. And proceeding to the interpellation, I wish to invite the attention of the COA, the welfare goods. Can we show the slide first, please?
While waiting for the slides, indeed,
yes, Madam Chair.
Indeed, the highest form of tradition in the House is the will of the majority.
Thank you, Madam
Chair. Salamat.
But that was very enlightening, Madam Chair. The exchange of arguments. And proceeding, Madam Chair, I wish to state for the record that in order to address three social problems, problem on malnutrition, problem on poverty, and even problem on calamity response, the OVP launched the Distribution of Welfare Goods Program, as well as the OVP Kalusugan Food Truck. I hope we can show the slide. However, Madam Chair, regardless of how ideal and how good these programs are, there are rules that we need to follow. And I wish to invite the attention, the first slide, please. There. To address the problem on malnutrition, calamity response, and hunger, the OVP launched the Distribution of Welfare Goods and Kalusugan Food Truck. And we laud this program of the Office of the Vice President. Nonetheless, Madam Chair, there are rules that need to be followed. And this is in line with the constitutional provision that public office is a public trust. And therefore, we need to follow these rules. I wish to invite the attention of the committee to Section 123 of PD 1445. This is about the audit of government offices. Kailangan po natin ng internal control. And then we proceed to Section 124, PD 1445 again. The responsibility of the head of the agency to install the internal control. Now, I wish to go to the COA. Ito po bang Section 123 at Section 124 were this complied with by the Office of the Vice President during the implementation, launching of this distribution of welfare goods as well as the OVP Kalusugan food truck?
Madam Chair, based on our report, the various deficiencies noted in the distribution of welfare
Madam
goods...
Madam Chair, can we ask the COA to limit the answer to the question which is being propounded? Nasunod po ba itong Section 123? Yes or no?
Based on our report, it is not strictly in accordance with Sections 123 and 124.
So it was not strictly complied with. In other words, there is no sufficient internal control. Tama po ba?
Yes, Madam Chair.
How about Section 124? Did the Vice President heed to the mandate of Section 124 that she has to make sure that she will install the internal control? Nasunod po ba o hindi ang Section 124?
Madam Chair, based on the COA report, there is a guidelines, but then the guidelines is not sufficient. So there is
In other words, Section 124 was not strictly complied with also by the OVP. That is the implication of the answer of the COA. Now, I wish to invite the attention of the COA to the documents that need to be provided for us to be able to liquidate the distribution of goods. One is distribution list. This is only few of the several documents. Two is property acknowledgement receipt. Four is request and issue slip. And five is deed of donation. Ito po bang limang documentary requirements na ito ay na-submit, na-provide ng OVP in the liquidation of the distribution of welfare goods? Yes or no lang po?
Madam Chair, based on our report or audit, some of distribution list was submitted, but some of the distribution list were not submitted. For particularly those mentioned in the report for the distribution of rice.
Thank you. And for us to have a better picture of what the COA meant by some were submitted, some were not, may I request the Secretariat to please flash the second slide. There. The report of the COA shows that 557,000 pansarap bonds dated October 5, 2023 has no proof of acknowledgement receipt. Does the COA confirm?
Madam Chair, yes po.
It also shows that 434,000 also pansarap bonds on December 14, 2023 lacks acknowledgement receipt of the school as well as proof of acknowledgement receipt. Does the COA confirm?
Madam Chair, yes po.
Can you please show again the... Does the COA confirm the 460,000 supply of rice? That there is no proof of acknowledgement receipt. This one is dated March 31, 2023. Does the COA confirm?
Yes, Madam Chair.
How about the 218,750 lacking in proof of acknowledgement receipt? This is dated March 31 also. This is also about rice. Does the COA confirm?
Madam Chair, yes po.
And ultimately, this one is really a huge amount. Malaking halaga po ito, Madam Chair. 62,764,000 distribution of year-end food packs on December 29, 2023. Wala ding proof of acknowledgement receipt. Does the COA confirm?
Yes, Madam Chair.
In other words, Madam Chair, this is almost 65 million which were not properly liquidated with the COA. Tanungin ko lang po ang COA, Madam Chair. What do you plan to do considering the huge amount which are not properly liquidated by the OVP?
Madam Chair, come again.
What does the COA plan to do with the almost 65 million unliquidated amount?
For this disbursement with not supported with complete documentation, we based on our recommendation, it will be required to the OBP to submit.
Until when are they allowed to submit the liquidation of this distribution of welfare goods?
Then also until what? Come again?
Until when are they allowed to submit?
Madam Chair, if not submitted within the time given with the OBP, we will address it or issue a notice of suspension.
Wala po ba tayong guidelines when it comes to the prescriptive period kung kailan tayo magsasubmit ng documentary requirements to explain the distribution of welfare goods? This is almost 65 million, Madam Chair. And yet, this is not properly liquidated. Nonetheless, Madam Chair, let me proceed to the second concern, the lapses in inventory management. We understand that the OVP likewise launched Kalusugan Food Truck. This is a six-wheeler truck which serves as a mobile kitchen in response to calamities. However, Madam Chair, upon reading of the report of the COA, there are three significant observations. Can we please flash the third slide? One, the food items are near expiry. Two, foods are not found in the storage. And three, they are placed in unventilated storage. Madam Chair, I understand that this is not a huge amount. However, I wish to invite the attention of the committee that this is the same observation that we had in the budget of the Department of Education, Madam Chair. So I wish to ask raise the concern that ano po ba itong failure to account the distribution of welfare goods? Sana naman hindi. But I'm afraid that this might be another case of ghost delivery. How do we know that this is not really a case of ghost delivery? Let us be reminded by the controversy hunting the pharmaceuticals. And let us be reminded as well by the provision on malversation under Article 217. Finally, Madam Chair, regarding the lapses in inventory management, I think it is more prudent that we leave Kalusugan Food Truck to the management and implementation of the DSWD, which is the agency specialized on catering community service. And with that observation, Madam Chair, I hope that this will be not an incident similar to the one which transpired in 2015 kung saan may na-discovery po tayong ibinaon na 500 sacks of rice because they were not properly managed. These are observations, Madam Chair, which the attention of the COA and all the concerned agencies I really wish to call. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Salamat.
Madam Chair.
Yes, please.
I may clarify. The PAR is the post activity report was that is the lacking documents. That's not yes, for the record it is the post activity report, not the property acknowledgement receipt.
And may we know the significance of the post activity report?
The post activity report serve as the proof that there is an activity happened on the distribution.
Well, it is my humble submission, Madam Chair, that it is as significant as proof of acknowledgement of receipt after all. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Ngayon, ikaw, bilang Pilipino, ano ang masasabi mo at reaksyon sa balitang ito? Mag-iwang ka ng komento sa ibaba at atin pong babasahin isa-isa.